We spoke that morning.
Right after he had...
He called me from the hockey. He woke up that morning and kissed my legs. He used to kiss whatever body part was sticking out of the sheets. And then I got a phone call from him from the hockey rink. He's there, you know, dressing up, getting ready to play hockey. Mm-hmm. And he's like, honey, I'll be home between 6 and 7. How about some chicken tonight with extra gravy and lots of TV and a little sex? I was like, deal. I'll see you at 6. So I started preparing, you know, to go to the market. And then I get the phone call that something's wrong with Alan, that I had to drive down to L.A. I knew something was really, really wrong when we pulled up to the curb. I pulled up to the curb, and there was a spiritual worker there, a spiritual guidance person with a Bible.
Oh, my gosh.
And when I saw her standing there, my heart sank, and I remember dropping my water bottle. And my heart sank to my stomach when the doctors, you know, they were explaining what happened to him. And I'm listening. And he said, I'm sorry to tell you, Mrs. Thicke, but your husband has expired. And I was like, what? Aww.